Last time on True Magnum TV.
First sheep, first goat.
I have a wall of different size photos of all the sheep I've been on, and that's special to me. I mean, that's a piece of when I'm an old guy, got drool out of the corner of my lip in my rocking chair, I'll still enjoy that, I'm sure. And then pass that to my kids, they'll see all the places I've been. So, you know, that's pretty unique. Seeing my kid shoot his first one and be in my picture, that's special too, really special.
Oh my goodness, that's unreal.
Congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
For me, it didn't start yesterday, the day before that, or the day before that. This goat hunt, for me, started in 2005.
Hunting season has begun. And these men will put it all on the line for the hunts of a lifetime. This is True Magnum TV. In British Columbia, James Brion and Derek Stevens have completed a successful mountain goat hunt and are preparing to explore a valley in search of the moose, elk, and caribou that the camp log and old timers' map indicated they would find.
This country is huge. When you come into these areas, you really don't know what to expect. Like, if things have been good in the valley and they haven't had a lot of predation problem and the balance is, you know, you could be in for incredible hunting, and that's what we're hoping for. That's what we're doing here. If we can come in here ahead of clients and find that we've got a great spot to hunt, that's good for everybody. Sometimes you come into these valleys, though, and things have happened in the past that have caused problems, you know. And when you start seeing those signs, you know, seeing those signs of lots of old wolf scat, you're not seeing the moose, that's a problem. You're not seeing the caribou, that indicates a problem. No elk, the ungulates that live down low, you hate to see them missing.
I bet none of those 50 restaurants up in Nelson make an elk onion and cheese sandwich.
I bet you're right. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I don't know what they're missing. I'm surprised we haven't seen anything but goats and sheep here, that's for sure.
It's pretty country.
Mm-hmm. That could be good for a caribou or a bear. A moose.
They should all be right here.
That's right.
They don't even know if they're missing out.
They don't. They didn't look at the map.
Mm-mm.
What are they thinking? It's so beautiful, though, I can't. If we rode clear to the base of that mountain there and didn't see nothing, it'd still be way worthwhile.
Absolutely. Yeah, we should at least go up there and check for some sign.
Yeah. If nothing else, probably one of the prettiest rides and prettiest days I'll ever experience anywhere.
Yeah, how many times in our lives are we going to be in a place like this, right?
I know, right? You just got to enjoy it.
It's worth taking a look around the corner. Much for sign up here.
No. Not for a while. What do you think?
I think, like you said, we probably overshot our range a little bit.
For an early fall anyway, huh?
Uh-huh.
Well, I hate to leave this valley, but...
Shall we?
We shall. One last look. Probably never be here again.
Sad thought, isn't it?
Kind of is, yep.
True Magnum TV is proudly presented by Cooper Firearms of Montana, Hornady, accurate, deadly, dependable, Everly Stock, Phone Scope, and Global Rescue.
You know, it's a privilege to hunt with Abram always. I've been hunting with him for over 15 years, but this little trip is a little bit special because we've got a few days to hunt together, and he's going to do the hunting, which surprised him, and he was taken off guard when I told him that I wanted him to hunt. So he's going to look for a mule deer. That's a good buck. You want him?
Yeah.
That's a really good buck. Oh, Abram? Yeah, we're good. Atta boy. Nice job.
Boy, last minute. That's a pretty management buck.
Nice deer. That looked like a management buck to me. Good shot.
Thank you.
Nice one. Good eyes. Holy smokes.
Yeah.
Wow. Look at that, is a hoss. And heavy, holy smokes. I can't believe that this is your first desert mule deer. Honestly, that was shocked me.
Thank you. Well, you know, one of the things about the Sonora bucks are they're the big frames is what's very impressive. This buck in particular is a management buck for Chaparral, but I know it's a trophy for a lot of people.
It's
a trophy for me.
Absolutely.
You know? It's very special.
Honestly, I'm so happy for you. I'm so glad we just decided to do this and to have the opportunity to hunt together, me letting you hunt. The guide became the hunter, and I'm glad to be part of that.
You drive conservation, so you should be rewarded. True Magnum's hardcore store has the gear tested by the true professionals in the field. And every purchase earns Magnum bucks, getting you closer to your next adventure. True Magnum, adventure lives here.
On Mexico's Baja Peninsula, Bull Morgan is on yet another scouting mission to determine the feasibility of conducting conservation hunts for a newly designated subspecies of mule deer.
Come down here to set up a new program. First thing, we have to run through the process and make sure it's a viable program. We've been doing sheep hunts down here for several years, and the deer, we can get permits through the UMA, which is like a controlling agency in a small group of people. The Baja Blacktail just got recognized as a new subspecies of the mule deer family. You got the mule deer from all over the western states, and then you get to the coast, it's blacktail, and goes all the way from Alaska down the coast through California, and then now they've just recently, last few years, called this a Baja Blacktail.
The last time we shot two males together, yesterday evening, once in that area, we see the whole the line right in it, on the end of the in the bottom.
The three brothers I deal with are, the oldest is Francisco. I call him Panchito, it's a slang. That's how I met him first, so I always just call him that. Francisco, he's the hunting guide and kind of the strong guy of the bunch. The middle brother is the interpreter, Eduardo. Had a little bit of college. And the youngest is Alan. And Alan's always does whatever. I mean, he's just the helper. The third is the youngest brother. And we load him up with water sometimes. He's got 40 water bottles in his pack. Always hits some music on or whatever. He's the one that has no true responsibility, but it's always there to help. And it's always pretty good time when you get him clicked in.
Like a giant red lizard. The red-bellied Baja lizard.
I must have needed the rest because I had some crazy dreams last night.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, my gosh.
Any moose hunting dreams?
No. No, I was in my brother's wedding, which that happened a year ago, and I was missing it. I was supposed to have a tux on. Instead, I was in the basement of the church with nothing on, hollering at my wife to bring me my tux. Never did happen. I missed his wedding, which reminds me I need to text him and tell him congratulations because he just had a kid last night. Well, his wife had a kid.
That's pretty awesome.
Yep. We'll just go look at some brand new country.
Yeah, brand new country should be good for a change of luck.
Mm-hmm. It's funny when you're out here, the eating is a little different.
You count calories in reverse.
In reverse, yeah.
How many can I get?
And it's like, well, you know, I might rather have that on these, but this has more calories. Like, I need to get up the mountain. Okay, now how about some syrup?
Yeah, now, exactly.
Now we're getting somewhere. All right, we have a sugar crash here this afternoon.
James and Derek are starting to race the clock in their efforts to find the moose that were indicated in the camp log and old timers' map. They have searched the lowlands and are now pushing into the higher pockets.
And now we're bushwhacking. We'll have to find more of a trail than this or we won't be able to get our moose out.
I know. I don't think this is it.
Ah, man. Like you need the advantage on me? Gotta go stand on a rock so you look even bigger? Seriously? Had so much flooding here in the past. We had a little bit of a trail. Don't know if we lost it or it's in this washout somewhere. Hopefully we find it. Otherwise this day is just scratch. You think this is it? No?
Yeah, wishful I don't thinking. Know.
At least it's like a game trail. Maybe we can get game up and down it. Comes right out of that wash. I thought maybe it was our trail. Oh, I want an orange really bad.
In Mexico's Baja region, Bo Morgan and his local guides are on day one of test hunting an area for Baja blacktail deer. As is often the case, before the benefits of conservation hunting take hold, the densities of game are low due to local meat hunting pressures. Already, it is apparent that the men have their work cut out for them.
Right, you're gonna spread it off right here, and you're gonna keep walking. If we can move something, you're gonna watch it. You can shoot it. If they're a really big one, don't shoot it. Leave it to breed with the other one.
Yeah, for the other guy. Yeah. No, it's more important to do that. The hard part's in here. We're sheep hunters, so they've never had the opportunity to hunt these deer. We're 15 for 15 on really good rams, so I'm trying to. You want to hunt the deer, but you got to be able to get into them and hunt them. The problem is you get up on the side and see them in these thick vegetation. You can't get back down and get to them and make a stalk. It's really hard. You lose them in here. So just kind of figure out what's going to work in here, and it's part of the working out the details. They know where their deer are. They see them a few times, but you got to be able to see them and then get to within shooting range. Could be the hardest piece.
Right.
Where'd you get that?
In a tree. Someone leave it.
Yeah, be careful, because anyway, get the it's for...
I wouldn't think.
Yeah.
You say you skipped. Someone leave it there.
I think from now on, I'll be in charge of my own water.
What's the word?
Oh, just looking around.
Hey, easy boy.
I think I see a trail over there on that ridge over.
On the other ridge?
Yeah.
Well, at least we know where it is.
Yeah, it's a start.
Might be a go back to go.
Yep.
Do not go directly to jail. Do not pass go. Do not collect 200. Well, maybe this ridge will get us there. Yeah, that's the trail right there. Look at that. Only missed it by a ridge. Well, the old timers were here.
Yeah.
Long time ago, though. I wonder how many trees have fallen across it since then.
We will find out.
Yes, we will. Oh, this was gonna be easy day.
Where was that in the memos?
The men are seeing signs that this trail hasn't been traveled in a very long time.
In these areas that haven't been hunted much, all the trails through it can grow dim in just a season or two. Sometimes a quick few mile mission or a few hour horseback ride can turn into hours and hours of just getting there. Back home, you throw this piece away, right? Not here, packed it in. Like 14 calories there. I packed all the way up here.
Exactly.
Yeah, we're not seeing much game in this valley. This is the second day in a row. We're bushwhacking, we're on old trails, we're having a hard time. And we get to this waterfall. And it looks like it's the end of the line, and Derek's thinking we're gonna walk from here. And I'm thinking, we've horsebacked for kilometers and kilometers over the last few days and seen nothing, not a hair. And we're gonna scale a waterfall and walk up to the end of this valley. Why? Just to say we did it. Wouldn't you know it, Derek sniffs out a trail that we can get the horses up. But I'm not so sure it's horse trail.
Right here, in front of us now. It's gonna be in that draw coming out to the left.
Did you hear that? We got him going. It works here too.
That's awesome.